was first course that I was asked to teach was business policy. Business policy then, and now it is strategic management. And it used to be a compulsory course, and I understand it is still. So policy was a very important subject for all of us, and my MBA from my municipal 72 got a good exposure to various dimensions of policy, and the today's word is strategy. So when I was coming, when Neeraj requested me to say a few words, and then what's the name of the lady? She disappeared. It doesn't matter. So words of wisdom. So I was trying to reflect as to what would be those words of wisdom. And over the last 45 years plus, because as a student, I still consider myself as a student. And so I'm still trying to know what exactly the word strategy means, what word policy means, what disruptions means, all kinds of things would cross your mind. And that was also happening when I was driving my car. So suddenly what flashed in my mind, maybe I would like to change, share with you a thought which has been a constant preoccupation with me. And that is, it is not a framework. It is not what you have in form of technology. It is, to my mind, context is the king. It is the context which determines everything, including decisions. You may have a small business, or you may have a very large business, multinationals and so on and so forth. At the end of the day, every CEO, including his team, has to take care first of the context. Now, this context is continuously changing, nobody would deny that. If you read the books, two mega trends are influencing the globe. One, globalization itself, the trend of globalization. And the second one is technology. Now, technology itself is a huge, huge subject. India has lost the race because we have been continuously borrowing what I call. They are living on received wisdom till date. Whether it is making of steel. And making of steel in India is more than 100 years old today. But yet we are borrowing technology. Or whether it is some developments in IT, or CRM, or ERP. We are continuously borrowing till date. And we are living on what would I use? Received wisdom. Now in this context, I wanted to correct. Phir udhaar ho gayi hai, maine dupar gayi thi. So, the developments of IT have played a very important role, no denying. But it is not IT alone. It is technology which is ruling the entire globe. And the development of technology are so rapid, so fast. There are mature industries like steel. There are sunset industries like copper and aluminium. But then there are sunrise industries also. And in each one of them is technology which is driving. And today the development of manufacturing technology, 3D technology, which is making a case that the whole manufacturing advantage, which low-cost countries like China, maybe India to some extent would go back to a developed country. Why? So it is the technology which is the key for all these, call it disruptions, call it rapid, but in spite of all that, what we keep on hearing, what is permanent, and the word comes up, change is permanent. If you don't change, you will disappear. Adaptive behavior has been a thought present in all the literature for a long time. If you can't adapt, examples. One is the example of Kodak. Have you heard of Kodak? Would you like to use Kodak camera today? Would you like to use man Kodak camera? Ek engine para free de denge aap. And Kodak was one of the most cited examples in the management books. And now they have to hide chapter for mentors. Kodak's labs used to be outstanding labs. And Kodak gave all the technology to have mobile camera to Samsung, to Nokia. But in their own scheme of things, they thought Rolls would rule. Sare camera, Rolls. Phir jao Kodak ke studio mein usko develop kara. Aur abhi Kodak gaya ho gaya, Rolls gaya ho gaya, most visible brand of globe after Coca-Cola is to be Kodak. Listen. Why they disappeared? Because they were glued, the CEO were glued that there is something which cannot challenge our leadership. Now, it's very difficult to accept anybody that tomorrow we will not be leaders. We'll be dethroned. But it's very difficult thought. So now, these kind of assumptions will be made. They got caught in that. What is the other word for that? Success is the biggest threat. Success traps you. Success blinds you. Success binds you. And your death is there. Now when it comes, nobody knows. The three giants of auto, America. Do you know that? They gave automobiles to the world. GM, Ford, Chrysler. They taught Toyota how to make cars. Today they are inviting Toyota to tell them how to have efficiency in building. The Toyota manufacturing building. They are asking for that. So, there is nothing permanent. You call it disruption, you call it rapid, anything. But recognize the fact that your leadership is the threat and all that you need to do is keep on. A. List the assumptions on which you are making important decisions. B. Challenge the assumptions. Will they hold true? If not, just go back. Some 15 years back or so, year was 97-98, Bill Gates, have you heard of Bill Gates? Say yes for my satisfaction.
Yes.
So you're supposed to know. Okay, so he has heard of Bill Gates. Bill Gates was being questioned by a congressional team. Congressional team kya hoti hai? MPs, jo party senate members. Aur question tha, investigation tha, ki tum perpetrate kar rahe ho killing of competition. Tum dominance perpetrate kar rahe ho. Because 90% market share belongs to Windows and the operating system. Bill Gates was questioned by 13 odd brilliant, if they are brilliant, I do not know. Say after tomorrow, it will come out whether Trump or Clinton. But they were the likes of that, questioning Bill Gates. So at some point of time, somebody asked, Sir, Bill Gates, don't you think you are monopolizing the computer? He says, I am monopolizing. If you want to know the true meaning and a brand of monopoly, it is not the Windows, it is not Bill Gates, it is not Microsoft, but it is Coca-Cola. Coca-Cola was created in Atlanta in 1880. 100 years have passed. Till date, Coca-Cola has not changed the formulation. The formulation has to be what it was, otherwise brand would die. And Bill Gates was saying, who IT industry? Every day there are changes and we have to spend a lot of money in R&D spending. 25 non-profits today, and if you now then get, and if I don't go, you will die. Words of wisdom, of course. Thank God, full of practical reality, that there are industries where this rapidity is so much that you have no clue what is happening. But in spite of that, IBM still, after several came back, Microsoft still. And who knows what will happen to Apple tomorrow, because there are articles coming. Ab kya kya ho gaya Apple. So you may have all kinds of prowess with you, but at the end, what kind of assumptions you are making to take those important decisions? And I mandate, in my little wisdom of last 45 years, context, repeat with me. बोल तो सकते हो, नींद तो उड़ा सकते हो, क्या सोते ही रहोगे? बोलो जोर से,
context
is the king.
And
it is context that we matter. India ke context, America ke context. आज सुबह जब मैं आया था तो इकोनॉमिक टाइम्स में इतना अच्छा आर्टिकल आया और जैसे इंडियन गदगद हो गए, गदगद समझते हो, रोंगटे खड़े हो गए. क्यों हो गए? क्योंकि सुरेश प्रभु हमारे जो रेलवे मिनिस्टर हैं, he has motivated 30 lakh people, 30 lakh are the employees of railways. And railway is one of the oldest operation of our country. तुमको मालूम है कमाई के railway in India में? तुमको मालूम हो भी नहीं सकता है कैसे होगा? पढ़ा ही नहीं. Anybody like IAMS and XLRI? They may say, sir, IAMS are jailing for their own achievements when we interact with them. But whenever we meet XLRI students, we find they are always worried about synergy through group work. That's the beauty of XLRI. That is our culture. So, once again, thank you for inviting me to sharing little ideas. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.